You have to start with tomatoes, really ripe tomatoes. And I come out here and I pick some out. There's some nice red ones in there. And then I go through the plants and I'll just keep finding more and more until I have enough to fill my bucket. And then I'll bring it in the house.
Hi, I'm Kathleen. And I have a large batch of salsa to make today. So I am going to show you how I make salsa. It probably is pretty much the way everyone else does, but I'm going to give you step-by-step instructions.
Okay, as you can see, I have quite a few tomatoes today. So now I need to get busy and start cutting these puppies out.
I'm going to start with the small tomatoes first because there are so many of them. You need to wash them really good and de-skin them. It's very time consuming, totally boring. It's hard on the feet, but these have the sweetest flavor. So just get them. They're not too dirty to start with, but there is a little bit of speck on them. So I'm going to have fun doing these. I have a lot of them. Okay, so I have my first clean batch of tomatoes, and I will put them inside the processing bowl, and I'm ready to. I've marked my bowl because I got tired of trying to figure out how to get the lid to go on. So I put two magic markers in, and once they line up, then I know that it's good to go. Of tomatoes.
Okay, I've got a
big pot here. This will be totally full by the time I'm done today. I'm going to put them in here. Now I think the next time I do the tomatoes, I'm going to add the peppercinis and maybe some onions to it because I find that it mixes up better if there's a few tomatoes with the onions and or the garlic or whatever else because it gives it a little bit of liquid and it helps it process a little bit better. In this batch of tomatoes, you'll notice I have a few of the little yellow ones. I'm not particularly fond of the taste of these tomatoes by themselves. They aren't sweet, but they add an interesting texture when you make a salad, so I like to have them in my garden. What they do for your salsa is they add a little color. They put in some yellow. So I'm going to clean these up and process them, and I'm also going to add maybe some onions or something else with it this time. All the stems, I keep in a little pile here, and they will go into my compost because I compost absolutely everything that composts. This can be a really long, drawn-out process. It's a good thing to have some nice, quiet music on in the background. Last thing you want is to listen to something hard, rock and roll. I don't listen to rap, but something like that would not be good either. You want to listen to something that's going to relax you. Okay, I decided to go with the onions first. I don't do a lot of cutting them up, just a little bit. Because the food processor pretty much takes care of the rest for them. Okay, I just finished doing the onions and this batch of tomatoes. And you can see it's pretty well mixed up here. I think I did this a little bit longer than the first batch, because I like to have different textures to the tomatoes. I like some of them really fine, I like some of them chunky. That gives my Pico de Gallo a lot of texture and body. I can't tell you exactly how many tomatoes and onions and peppercinis I'm going to use right now because I do it to taste, but I will write it down and I will have it on this film before. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and start adding a few peppercinis with this next batch of tomatoes. And I save the juice in a little bowl because I reuse it, and if you don't have a bowl or something, it's going to go all over the floor or your counters or whatever. Ah, just like that one, just squirted all over me. Okay, because each one is filled with a bunch of juice. I use peppercinis because my husband does not like really hot sauce, and this gives it the flavor of some peppers without burning your mouth off. Now I add a little bit of sugar to mine. My number three child gives me a little some grief over it, but it's just what I do. I think it brings up the sweetness in the tomatoes. Also, since this is going to be a pretty full pot, it's like about 2 tablespoons of salt. No, let's go 3. Okay, and then we'll adjust this taste accordingly. Okay, I'm going to add some cilantro to this batch. I've got about a handful here. Make sure you wash it really well. My experience with cilantro is that I don't know why, but it has sand and stuff in it. You don't want any of that in your salsa. So just wash it up and throw it in the processor. Okay, I finished up with all my small tomatoes. I found that if I take the tomatoes instead of cutting them directly in half, you cut it off to the side a little bit, then you can just take the core out like that. Makes it a lot easier, and then you don't have to do the little wiggly thing. I like firm yet ripe tomatoes. By doing that, you get nice, red, fully ripe flavor. And unlike bananas, you don't want your tomatoes too ripe. Well, it's been 3 hours, and now I'm done. My back hurts, my legs hurt, but I've got lots of salsa made, and I have about a half a gallon of VA juice. So, just a second, and I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, here's our pot of salsa. As you can see, there is quite a bit. It'll go over well tomorrow at the party. Now I just have to get the right chips to go with it. We're having a big party for a friend of ours that's going to go stay in another country for about 6 months or maybe longer. There's a glass of my V8. I've already drunk, whatever, a couple of glasses of it because I ran out of room in the fridge. And then I wanted to show you what I do with my salsa. I use this wonderful Super Saver, and I baggy it up, and it takes the air out of it and helps it to stay a little bit longer in the fridge. Also makes it very convenient to give away as gifts. Now, I also want to show you one more thing real quick before we run out of time. And those are the only tomatoes left. I ran out of room in my pot, as you could see, and this is it. These little ones, I didn't use those in there because they are so good to eat, and they're really teeny tiny. But that's it. And now, seeing how I make salsa.